Hey everyone, thank you so much for tuning in. A while back, I made a commitment to myself that I would either write in my blog or do a blog video once a week. And you may have noticed, if you've been following along, that I have taken a little bit of a hiatus from doing that. And I am now recommitting myself to that goal. Also, knowing that sometimes we can't be rigid with goals and we need to be flexible around goals when it comes to self-care and making sure that we stay within our window of tolerance in terms of how much is on our plate or how much we're dealing with mentally, cognitively, emotionally. It's sort of like we want to respect the window of tolerance, and we also want to grow the window of tolerance. And that means being mindful about where we're at and also being sure to rest when we need to, and to grow our set of tools in order to, for me, like still hold myself accountable to the things I know are going to actually make me feel good about myself and the things that I need to do for self-care, too. I don't know about you all, but often when I am going through a difficult time, which I have been recently, my self-care suffers the most, which is kind of like, what the heck? Why, that seems like the opposite of what we need. But I think often when we're going through difficult times as trauma survivors, it's because our attachment needs have been ruptured in some way, or we've been going through like emotional triggers. Again, the difference between an emotional trigger and a PTSD trigger. PTSD trigger is sort of like this textbook, was in a car crash. Now, whenever I get into cars, my anxiety spikes. And it's sort of easy to identify the trigger. It's easy to for others to identify the trigger and for care to be received, to be given, to find the language for what we need, etc. So it's the difference between maybe a car crash in childhood trigger to like childhood itself, emotional trigger. Meaning like someone who experienced a lot of neglect, emotional neglect in childhood is someone who as an adult could experience a lot of, sometimes emotional triggers around care, around relationships, around attachment needs. Old attachment wounds. Sometimes, even though I've done a whole bunch of work around old attachment wounds, like an event could happen that could really set me off in terms of an emotional trigger. And sometimes they can last a long time until safety is felt again or repair is felt again. And so I've been doing a lot of rereading lately around attachment theory. And a big word that comes up for me when I read attachment theory, our ability to connect with other people, attach with other people in healthy ways. A big word that comes up for me a lot is the concept of attunement. So, in sort of simple terms, which they should be, attunement is like baby smiles. Mom smiles, baby and mom smile together, and they are attuned. Mom smiles, baby smiles back, mom and baby smile together, and they are attuned. And then we've got misattunement. Well, I'll give one more attunement, a little more complicated. Like, baby cries, because that's the only way that baby can express their feelings. And mom says, "Oh dear, my baby's crying. Let me change the diaper. Oh, that wasn't it. Baby's still crying. Mom's still attuned. Let me give the baby a bottle." baby, you know, is soothed by the bottle. Baby was hungry. Mom met baby's needs. And now they're attuned again. Everybody's feeling good and cared for, and as though they can identify the need and provide care too. So misattunement is baby cries. Mom tries one thing and then doesn't work, and mom gets really upset. Baby cries more. They're misattuned. Baby smiles. Mom just sort of has a flat affect. Baby cries, you know, baby pleads, baby tries other things. Baby's devastated that their primary caregiver couldn't attune with them. So, as you can see, this starts really early in our lives. It starts in infancy. It's really, attunement is really important throughout our development in childhood. And it's important now in the relationships we have as adults too. So, that being said, it's good to know what our needs are, know how to express our needs, and be in healthy relationship with others, our partners, our friends, our family, you know, good boundaries about who we want in our life and who we don't want so much in our life. But the most important relationship, I think that we're all gonna have in this life is our relationship with ourselves. Because when we've got that down and we have a healthy relationship with self, it affects everything else. It affects all of our other relationships too. So I want to do a series of videos starting with this one around ways to attune with self and ways to provide self-care. We talk a lot about self-care in the mental health world, but like, if we can actually attune with ourselves, remember those examples about baby and what baby needs, we're all just big babies, and now it's our task to take care of ourselves, and it's our big task to take care of ourselves if those attachment needs weren't met as babies, as children, in really pivotal developmental stages. It's a huge task, but it's one that really, really pays off. I've done a lot of this personal work, and it's not linear, as my therapist reminded me of this week. Like, sometimes something can happen to trip us up. All that work is not for nothing, though. I mean, it still counts. We bounce back a lot quicker and we have more tools at our disposal. But this is ongoing work. It's just something that people with histories of trauma, like, have to be aware of and mindful of. So what I'm going to do today is teach you one way, one tool for self-attunement and for self-care, and that is journaling. So I'm going to give you the prompts that, first of all, go to CVS or go to like your local cute like sells journals and other pens and cute stuff store and buy yourself the journal you want and the pen you want. It is great to like physically write when you're journaling versus notes app or typing. I also know that sometimes we're gonna do this stuff in our head when we're walking, or we're gonna notes app this stuff, but as much as you can, try to get a journal for yourself, for your own special self-attunement time. And I'm just gonna go ahead and get into the prompts. So, should you choose to go on this journey with me around self-care and self-attunement, and start with this journaling exercise, I'm just going to give you the instructions now. Here's what I want you to do. In your journal, every day, write the day of the week, write the date. 8/9/22 is today. Like, Tuesday, 8/9/2022. And just write it out. And every day when you start your day, wake up in bed, pull out your journal, make your coffee first if you need to. That's a nice ritual, journal and coffee. What I want you to do is write down three things that you're grateful for. Right now, looking around in this moment, I'm grateful for my dog snuggling next to me. I'm grateful that I get to work from home in the AC. And I'm grateful for all of you watching this video right now and supporting me. So three things that you're grateful for. It doesn't have to be deep. It can be. I am grateful to be alive in the fabric of time in this universe right now, or like my dog. Either one is fabulous and counts. The second prompt, morning prompt two, is three things I am grateful for about myself. Now we're getting a little deeper, and this is about self-attunement, relationship with self. Examples. I am grateful to myself for doing this video today, and I'm going to post it even though it will be imperfect. That's about me and me, right? I am grateful for myself for getting to the gym this morning and getting in the pool. It felt really good. Gave me some good chemicals in my body, and it was a great way to start my day. I find water so healing. Good job, me. Oh, and then like an award ceremony applause moment after each one, like, woo, go you. I get the pool patch on like my Boy Scout fest. Third thing I'm grateful for about myself, I am hydrating well today. That is good self-care. It is me and me. No one has done that for me. That's it. And I feel, check in about how you feel after you do the three things you're grateful for in your world and the three things you're grateful for about yourself. I feel pretty good having just said that to my like iPhone right now. Be with that. At this point, last thing to do in the morning is like, all that considered, what is your intention for the day? I intend to post this video, engage with this video, like put myself out there, be vulnerable. What are your positive intentions for your day? Okay, that's it. That's the morning journal. It will take you 5 minutes to do. So it's a really lovely way to sort of set the scene in your mind for the day and give yourself a fighting chance to like be in a positive mindset while you're starting your day. Next, I'm going to give you one more journal prompt for today, and I have simply named this The Questions. Capital T, capital Q, The Questions. I've been a therapist for 15 years. I'm a trauma therapist. I'm a trauma healer. I am healing from trauma. And over the years, I've just kind of perfected these questions because I feel like it gets at what it is we need to get at when we are feeling, do this when you are feeling bad, not yourself. You don't know what you're feeling, or especially when you're feeling emotionally flooded or emotionally overwhelmed or emotionally triggered, all the same thing. So the questions are, question number one, how am I feeling? And what you can do when you ask this question, I mean, I really want you to ask yourself, how am I feeling? And leave room for the answer. Sometimes when like I'm emotionally triggered, I know exactly how I'm feeling. Pissed off, like sad, wounded, you know, like whatever. And it comes out really fast. And there are other times where I just feel sort of disconnected and I need to connect with myself. So in order to help yourself do this, what I want you to do is take your right hand and put it over your heart. And take your left hand and put it on your tummy. Close your eyes. And breathe. And you can feel your chest fill up with breath. And your belly expand. And ask yourself, really, little buddy, like we are both mom and baby here. We are checking in with self. We are self-attuning. I call myself little buddy in these times. How am I feeling? Okay. And then write it down. The next question is, why? So what just happened in my world to make me feel this way? The next question, is there anything from my past that could be coloring this situation? This is not a yes or no question. It's usually a yes question. And write this down too. Write about it. Like, really take the time to write a few paragraphs, even. Or bullet points. Skip it if you don't know it, but try. Is there anything from my past that could be coloring this situation? And write about it. So it's, how am I feeling? Something we think it's just like, you know, if we don't go any deeper, it's just like the present day. Like, oh, I'm feeling pissed off at my partner. Why? Because they didn't remember this important thing about me that I was really hoping that they would remember. We could stay right there on the surface, or we could go deeper. Is there anything from my past that could be coloring the situation? Oh, yes. I experienced a bunch of neglect. People forgot me before. This is bringing up an abandonment wound for me, right? Like, go there with yourself. This pays off. Then I want you to ask yourself, next question, what is the fear? Like, what am I really afraid of here? Being unlovable, being alone, being left, being forgotten. What am I afraid of? Write that down, you know? Next, now that I know, my fear is that I'm unlovable. That's the ultimate fear. My next question can be answered, which is, and you can do another right hand over heart, left hand over belly. This is the emotion centers. The next question, now that I've asked myself and answered, what is the fear? This question is, what do I need right now? If I'm feeling unlovable, or my abandonment wound is up for me right now, is triggered for me right now, I might need to use I statements and tell my partner, hey, the story I'm telling myself right now is that you've forgotten me. The story I'm telling myself right now is that I'm not important to you. And I know that's not true, but it would go a really long way for me right now if you could give me some reassurances and tell me you love me. And maybe could we plan a special date together? What do I need right now? And then go ahead and ask for it. Don't keep it a secret. You don't have to anymore. We're adults. We can get our needs met. We can identify them. We can ask for them. We can know that we deserve to have our needs met. Okay. And then do it for 15 minutes. So sometimes it's an attachment thing we need from someone else. Sometimes it's like, oh, I'm feeling unlovable right now. You know what makes me feel loved from me? When I go to the gym and I go for a swim. So the next thing to write down in your journal is then do it for 15 minutes. Okay, 15 minutes, I'm still in this journal thing, so I can't go to the gym for a swim, but I'm gonna go after. But right now I'm gonna do a little bit of weights and some jumping jacks, because I know that helps, and that's a lovely thing to do for myself. Then return to your journal for the last question, which is, what is the bridge forward? Or what is the road forward? Like, all of these things considered that you've just processed with self, like, what am I gonna do next time? What did I just learn from this? There's pain, and then there's the wisdom we gain from it. You know, there's insights, there's this experience of self, like, attunement and self-love. Like, what is the bridge forward? Okay, in this example, like, I felt this attachment rupture. I'm gonna make sure I use I statements and not you statements next time. I'm gonna write that down. So that August 9th, 2023, I can flip back to this page and say, look what I don't do anymore. Like, look how much I've grown. Or September 9th, 2022, I can say, I did that again. This is a pattern. I've identified a pattern. And maybe October 9th, 2022, I can stop it quicker. I can give myself what I need in those moments. I can identify what I need and ask for those things. So I would love, 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 love to hear from folks about, folks who do these journal entries. I'd love for you to comment here and let me know what you've gotten from this, how it's worked for you. Commit to this. Like, if you want to do this, start with the three things I'm grateful for every morning to set your mind right. The three things I'm grateful for about myself to set yourself right and your relationship with self right, your intention for the day. And then whenever you need to, the questions, at least once a day. Would love to hear your feedback. Thank you so, so much for your patience and for tuning in today. I'll see y'all soon.